in an investigation that is literally life and death. For anyone who has reason to suspect they have cancer, any wait for answers feels like too long. And medically speaking, some waits can kill. With that as the backdrop, here's the headline. Some of America's military veterans, men and women, we all owe a tremendous debt to, are dying. They're dying needlessly because of long waits and delayed care at some U.S. veterans hospitals. At one hospital, patients died for one reason. They were made to wait too long to get a simple colonoscopy that would have detected cancer and saved lives. And what's worse, the VA knows all about its problems and has done almost nothing to prevent some veterans from dying who are dying for care. Here's investigative correspondent Drew Griffin keeping them honest.
To understand the problems with the VA, a good place to start is the Williams Jennings Bryan Dorn Veterans Medical Center in Columbia, South Carolina, where veterans waiting for simple gastrointestinal procedures like colonoscopy or endoscopy have been dying. Six so far confirmed. And sources tell CNN the number of vets dead or dying of cancer because they had to wait too long for diagnosis or treatment could be more than 20.
It's very sad because people died.
And they didn't have to die.
They paid the ultimate price.
At a veterans hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Stephen Lloyd is a private physician specializing in colonoscopies in Columbia, South Carolina. He is also one of the few doctors in the area willing to speak on the record.
People that had appointments had their appointments canceled and rescheduled much later. And in some cases, that made an impact where they went into a later stage and therefore lost the battle to live.
And this wasn't just some oversight by the hospital. Documents obtained by CNN show the hospital knew its growing waiting list and delays in care were having deadly consequences. Medical investigators reviewed the cases of 280 gastrointestinal cancer patients in Dorn and found 52 of the cancer cases were associated with a delay in diagnosis and treatment. CNN has obtained individual cases like this one, a vet who had to wait 9 months for a colonoscopy, a significant delay according to VA records, which would have impacted the stage at which he was diagnosed. Records indicate by the time this veteran had surgery, his cancer was at stage 3. A second patient had to wait 4 months for an appointment, 10 months for an endoscopy, at which time he learned he had later stage cancer of the esophagus. The internal VA report says without the delay, his cancer would have been diagnosed much earlier. And though the report doesn't say if the vet lived or died, it does say an earlier screening would have provided earlier detection with better survival.
There is a little problem that the VA had.
O'Neill Sessions, a Vietnam vet, is one of the lucky ones. He says VA doctors at Dorn Medical Center told him just this spring he didn't even need a colonoscopy. It's advice he ignored. So this fall, he had one on his own. And his private physician found and removed 4 polyps, 2 of which were precancerous. His doctor says had he waited another few years, he would have had colon cancer.
It's got to be a little disheartening.
Yes, it is. The VA is not doing the, my feelings is that the VA is not doing their pre-stuff that they should do to protect the veterans.
Most troubling of all is the problem here was identified. More money was given to fix the problem. And what happened? The waiting list grew.
We appropriated $1 million because VA asked for it.
Florida Congressman Jeff Miller is chairman of the House Committee on Veterans Affairs. Of the $1 million Congress specifically gave to Dorn to pay for care for vets on a waiting list, only a third was used for its intended purpose. Documents exclusive to CNN show at that same time, the waiting list kept growing. In just 5 months, from 2,500 patients to a backlog of 3,800. Some patients waiting 8 months for appointments.
They will say that we redirected those dollars to go somewhere else that was needed. Where would it be more needed than to prevent the deaths of veterans? These are real people that we're talking about that are being harmed, either made sick, will be sick in the future, or have died.
And it's not just delayed colonoscopies, and it's not just in South Carolina. The VA now says other facilities have been under scrutiny over possible delays in treatment or diagnosis. At the Charlie Norwood VA Medical Center in Augusta, Georgia, three veterans are confirmed dead as a result of delay in care, and internal documents show a waiting list there of 4,500 patients. The VA also investigated delays in Atlanta, Georgia, North Texas, and Jackson, Mississippi, and claims in Texas and Mississippi there were no adverse outcomes due to delays.
Well, long wait times and a weak scheduling policy and process have been persistent problems for VA. And both GAO and the VA's Inspector General have been reporting on these issues for more than a decade.
Deborah Draper with the Government Accountability Office has been reporting to Congress on the delays in care for years. She says it's so bad she and her staff have found evidence the VA hospitals actually try to cover up wait times, fudge numbers, backdate delayed appointments, just to try to make things appear better than they are. She says just getting someone to pick up the phone to make an appointment at a VA hospital can be difficult.
The care is being delayed. There's no doubt about it.
Well, it's unclear how long it's being delayed because no one can really give you accurate information.
And report after report, the Government Accountability Office makes recommendations, but the problems persist at many hospitals.
Nothing has been fully implemented that we know of at this point.
So you make recommendations and they say they're working on it.
Yes, and we will be following up.
In fact, time and time again, even at hospitals where veterans died waiting for care, administrators got bonuses, not demotions, according to congressional investigators. CNN's repeated requests for interviews with the VA have been denied, and even Congress has had its request for information ignored.
But unfortunately, if they treat members of Congress, the U.S. House, and the Senate this way, imagine how they treat the average veteran out there, the person who has served that's trying to get information from them. I can't imagine the grief that they may be going through.
As for the veterans waiting for care at Dorn VA Hospital in South Carolina, the VA would grant no interview, but told us the consult delay at Dorn VAMC has been resolved. Cases are now tracked daily and additional staff hired. But sources at Dorn, both patients and medical staff, tell CNN that's just not true. The problems continue, and veterans are still facing delays in care that could be killing them.
And Drew Griffin is joining us now. Drew, so this isn't getting any better. The veterans are just waiting and waiting. Is that right?
That's right. We've learned this is a waiting list system, the appointment system nationwide. It's antiquated, Wolf. It's not uniformly used hospital-hospital, and it just fails these veterans time and time again. We did learn that there was an internal system-wide review, but quite frankly, Congress, the Inspector General's Office, the Government Accountability Office, I've heard all this before, and our sources tell us it just doesn't seem to get any better.
The one thing we didn't see in your reporting is anyone responding to this directly from the Veterans Administration. I know you tried to get reaction.
Yeah, and this was kind of stunning. The VA's administration is really thumbing their nose at us, but also thumbing their nose at Congress. Let me tell you what we were told, Wolf. We requested an interview with the National Medical Director for the VA about what I think is a pretty serious issue. A public affairs officer told us right away the chances of that were slim to none, and then called back saying, well, in fact, the answer is no.